top story. The Uttar Pradesh Police has arrested a second accused in the Fatehpur Dalit girl assault case. Two are still absconding. Remember, the Dalit girl's limbs were chopped off by the men who were trying to rape her on Saturday. The latest crime has given the Congress more ammunition against Mayawati. In fact, Congress General Secretary Rahul Gandhi is in a race with the Chief Minister to visit the victim. He's expected to meet the girl in hospital shortly.
There is apathy towards these cases, as if they are not concerned. Either they are not concerned, or they are not afraid, or there is no feeling about the law and security of the women.
Dalit girls in their own houses are no longer safe in a state where a Dalit lady is the chief minister. We demand that the UP government make it safe for people from all sections, particularly women. Law and order has to be immediately restored.
Joining us, CNNIBN Sumit Pandey with more on this big news. Sumit, we heard the BJP there. We know that Congress General Secretary Rahul Gandhi intends to visit this victim in hospital. This surely is going to be a big headache for Mayawati, who champions the cause of Dalits, because elections are in 15 months Uttar Pradesh.
Well, Ananya, this is one issue on which over the last three and a half years, the Uttar Pradesh Chief Minister has repeatedly been accused or alleged by the opposition that she has not been able to rein in her MLAs who have gone berserk, a section of her MLAs. Now, for a chief minister who has very diligently built her image as that of an able administrator, in fact, if you remember the last elections, the entire campaign was basically based on ending Mulayam Singh Yadav's Gunda Raj. For the chief minister who would be facing elections 15 months from now, I think this is one issue on which she will have to tread very carefully, considering the fact that she has been over the years working on two planks. One is the social justice, and second being the that of a leader who can provide better law and order situation in the state. And if the opposition is going to target her on these issues, then actually she will have to show some sort of action against people within her party who are accused by the opposition of taking law into their own hands. In the past, there have been many instances, that of Bandha. There was an incident in Auraiya, Uttar Pradesh, where an irrigation engineer was targeted, allegedly killed by a BSP MLA. Her opponents say that although she has suspended these people from the BSP, but they have not been their membership has not been terminated. So politically, she has tread very carefully, considering the impact or the effectiveness of these local leaders within their domain. On one hand, but just by suspending them, she has sent across a message that she is taking action. But then on the other hand, she has very carefully nurtured or kept these people on her side. Because, right. 15 months from now, elections would be held. And very clearly, it's one plank which the BJP, the Congress and the Samajwadi Party, all her three political adversaries, are going to rake up in the days ahead.
Sumit Pandey, thanks very much for joining us with that. It's certainly the big news we're tracking very closely. In fact, we're getting figures from the National Crime Records Bureau for 2009 that show that UP has a serious law and order problem. UP ranks third after Andhra Pradesh and West Bengal. There are over 22,000 cases of crime reported in 2009 in Uttar Pradesh. In fact, the state recorded the highest percentage of violent crime in 2009 at 11.9%. 22% of all sexual harassment cases reported have been from Uttar Pradesh. There's actually been a 5% increase in crime against Dalits over the year 2007-08. Wonder how Mayawati would respond to that one.